The storyline of Assassin's Creed can be very confusing for some and very intriguing for others. The way it was laid out was incredibly mysterious and gave a lot of room for investment in the franchise. With a story which was so complex, it gave a lot of room for plot twists, revelations, and character development. In this video, I'm going to be going over 5 times that the Assassin's Creed franchise made us say, "Wait, what the fuck?" Keep in mind this video contains spoilers from the entire Assassin's Creed franchise, so you've been warned. Click off now if you don't want any kind of spoilers. During the modern day of Assassin's Creed 4, you spend a lot of time running around doing probably illegal things for a bloke who works in IT. He has you climb the scaffolding outside of buildings and sneak into your boss's office to steal sensitive data. If I wanted to keep my job at Abstergo Entertainment, I probably would have turned this guy down. But it's not until the very end of the game you realise this guy is actually a Sage, people with incredibly high concentrations of furtive DNA imbued with the memories of Aita, the dead husband of the modern day's main antagonist, Juno. It's a huge moment of revelation when you realise you've actually been helping the enemy all along. Assassin's Creed 1 was met with mixed reviews back in 2007, but I think one thing that can't be disputed is the almost eerie feel the mysterious modern day had. When you weren't killing Templar Knights in the Third Crusade, you were bartender slash assassin Desmond Miles, who over the course of the modern day slowly learned more about the Templars and Assassins and how they operated during the modern day. Nothing, however, could have prepared you for the very end scene in which Desmond lifts himself from the Animus to see blood everywhere, symbols and writing which only he could see due to his newly acquired Eagle Vision. This ending leaves the player with only questions and a thirst for a sequel. This ending was truly well planned out and definitely shocked me after the first time I played the game. If you thought the ending to Assassin's Creed 1 was a bit of a twist, then Assassin's Creed 2 would blow your mind. After waiting patiently for a sequel to Assassin's Creed, 2 years later, the critically acclaimed Assassin's Creed 2 was released. It explained what the blood was and why it was there. It also explained how Desmond acquired Eagle Vision. The story was hugely expanded, and with that came some more questions and confusion. However, it wasn't until the very end of the game that things got really crazy. As Ezio opens the vault underneath the Vatican, he enters to find a magical fucking space wizard god lady. You learn this woman is called Minerva and was part of a precursor race that existed 75,000 years ago and created the human race. She spends roughly 3 minutes talking, your head bursting with knowledge, and then she looks directly into the camera to address Desmond Miles, who wouldn't be born for another 500 years at the time of Ezio. With nothing left to say and a thirst for another sequel, the credits roll and Desmond says exactly what we're all thinking.
What the fuck?
Assassin's Creed used to have some of its best story elements as things you didn't even have to do, namely the truth in Assassin's Creed 2 and Brotherhood. The glyphs that were scattered all over Renaissance Italy, once collected, gave Desmond and the gang access to content which was truly mind-blowing at the time. Footage of Adam and Eve in the precursor land with these tall, shining towers carrying the Apple of Eden was truly a sight to behold, as it really gave an idea of the depth of the game's lore and universe, and added this sense of wonder to a world you didn't fully understand yet. Brotherhood took this aspect and integrated it seamlessly with Subject 16 himself, giving him the means to actually communicate with Desmond, meaning he could tell Desmond information he needed to know. One piece of information was regarding Desmond's son. This was a huge plot point still speculated about to this day, with the reveal of Desmond's son in the files of Assassin's Creed Syndicate. To me, the biggest and best ending to any Assassin's Creed game, and a moment which gave me far too many conflicting emotions, was the ending of Assassin's Creed Brotherhood. The modern day was at its peak during this game, just enough mystery and intrigue whilst also giving you a lot to do in the modern day. It took Desmond to Monteregione and then across Italy to Rome. This is where Desmond had been led to by Ezio, to finally find the apple so the Assassins could have the upper hand. Everything was going smoothly, no Templars in sight, until Juno uses the apple to take control of Desmond Miles and forces him to stab one of his closest friends, Lucy Stillman. This moment was a huge shock and incredibly emotional, as the game forces you as the player to do the deed yourself. You can try and escape, but all that will happen is Desmond getting closer and closer to Lucy until eventually he stabs her in the stomach with his hidden blade. But that's not all. After Lucy's death, Desmond collapses and falls into a coma while Juno spouts more riddles you don't have time to figure out because you're already crying and confused, and the wait begins again for the next installment of the franchise. thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If you want to leave me your biggest what the fuck moments in the comments, it would be much appreciated. Don't forget to like if you enjoyed and check out my channel and subscribe for more Assassin's Creed content. If you want to support myself and the channel, you can hit that top link in the description. Head over to Patreon for extra exclusive and early content, among many other rewards, for the minimum of just $1 a month, and it does help me out in this time of low revenue. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye!
Leaping from my places, rivers are flowing red. Now we're defying, now we're uniting. Go watching from the skies, these streets are burning up. There's dying fights here, I'm gonna take it to them all.